Hello and welcome to the Grand Line Review, your source for everything One Piece. And today, I'd just like to have a bit of a discussion regarding one of the most iconic villains in the series, a certain heavenly demon, and more specifically, how effective he was in that role. The desire to embark on this discussion stems from a video that I made an awfully long time ago now, where I selected what I believe to be the top 5 best villains in the series, and well, Doflamingo did not appear on that list. Ever since then, almost every second comment that appears on that video has either been asking why Doflamingo wasn't selected or directly questioning my sanity. So let's get into how Mr. Sunglasses fits into all of this and how I feel about him as a villain as a whole. And first of all, I would like to start by saying that Doflamingo is one of my all-time favorite characters in the series. His design, his abilities, his backstory, pretty much everything about him hits me strongly. But does that feeling alone make him one of the top 5 best villains in the series? Not necessarily. Because I mean, someone can tell me all they want that Hody Jones is their favorite character, but not even in the darkest timeline will he be considered one of the best villains in One Piece. But let's take a quick look at what Doflamingo has going for him in that regard. Throughout the large majority of the series, Doflamingo represented a very enigmatic and menacing presence. His character was essentially epitomized by 2 features, the first of which being a position of great power as a warlord of the sea, and the second being one hell of a smile. And these 2 features created a solid fear of the unknown. Because in the pre-time skip era, as much as we knew next to nothing about this man, what we did know was that if Luffy and the Straw Hats ever crossed paths with him, it would almost certainly be the end of them. And that feeling was well-founded, because when Doflamingo's time did come, he did not disappoint in terms of sheer overwhelming power. He was the strongest combatant that Luffy had taken on to date, well, excluding skirmishes against admirals and other such beings, and overcoming Doflamingo took an entire nation rising up in rebellion against him. In addition to that, he wasn't just evil for the sake of evil either, not really anyway, because Doflamingo did have an understandable past. I mean, I can't identify or empathize with his upbringing as a celestial dragon, but I do certainly understand how he ended up the way he did, which is an integral element in a strong antagonist. Plus, he was poised to be pretty damn intelligent as well, having positioned himself at the center of an extensive underground network, specializing in the trade of slaves and weapons, with many massive clients, all the while blackmailing the world government to attain a position as a warlord of the sea. This dude really did have it all going for him, and with a fascinating and quirky crew to complement it all. But for a quick recap, Doflamingo was an enigmatic, powerful, intelligent, and depth-filled figure. He's what I would call a good all-rounder, a jack of all trades if you will, but not necessarily a master of any. And to break this down, let's begin with our first key feature, being his enigma or mystery. Now this is problematic with any villain because in order to actually explore them, you need to abandon this feature entirely. And after being told the story behind Doflamingo and viewing his abilities in detail, this layer has all but disappeared from him. Well, except for what his eyes look like behind those sunglasses, and I would be very happy to never find out what they look like, in order to preserve that teeny tiny bit of mystery. But the thing is though, even when we put the mystery of Doflamingo into context, I still don't think it presents more than what other villains have been able to make from this feature. Because at the height of Enigma, all Doflamingo really was a big old question mark looming over the One Piece world, which I loved, but there was no fanatic desire to unravel that enigma. Whereas you look at a villain like, say, Blackbeard, and the mystery surrounding him have fueled the One Piece fanbase ever since his introduction. There is a lust for knowledge that he demands, whether it be how he was able to consume multiple devil fruits, or how he can be a member of the D clan when he shows such unusual behavior for a D-wielder. It doesn't matter what it is, the mystery is enthralling, and I don't just say that because we haven't solved them yet. They're just stronger conundrums to be presented to the audience than what Doflamingo represented. And it's certainly one of the reasons why I placed Blackbeard in my top 5 best villains list, but certainly not the only reason. But this video is not about Mr. Teach, so let's move on with the next factor for Doflamingo, which is strength. Now this one is problematic because you can't judge a character, be they good, bad, or neutral, via power alone. And you know what, if you did, then Doflamingo would stand even less of a chance of making the top 5 best villains list with some of the absolute monsters in this series. With that said, strength is important to analyze in context. Because for example, Kaido is such a revered presence in this world, not so much because we know anything surrounding his character, but simply because of the godlike power that he has access to. But on the other end of that spectrum, a good villain certainly does not need that level of power to operate, and I'll be using Arlong as an example of this. Lots of people went absolutely mad when I ranked Arlong over Doflamingo, and many of them cited Arlong's physical weakness as some sort of reasoning behind that, but Arlong was exactly as strong as he needed to be for the time period, just as Doflamingo was an appropriate level of power to be perceived as a legitimate threat against Luffy in his era. So the question of strength becomes pretty irrelevant. Well, not irrelevant so much as the question shifts to, okay, so what does a villain do with that strength? And in Doflamingo's case, as crazy as the events of Dressrosa were, I don't think he did quite enough with what he had to work with, which was an absurd base strength, agility, and durability, as well as one of the most broken Devil Fruit abilities, awakened Devil Fruit abilities, I should add. And when I look back at how he used the power he had, I generally generally can't see myself ranking those deeds anywhere near something like Arlong, who used what little power he had to put Nami through a truly horrific childhood, or say Sakazuki using his incredible strength to kill Ace. And yes, Doflamingo did put Trafalgar Law and King Riku and an entire nation through a horrendous ordeal, but it just doesn't have anywhere near the same overall effect, not on me anyway. And I don't know why that disconnect is there, but I just don't feel the fear of Doflamingo's power as much as I do Sakazuki, or you know what, even Arlong oddly enough. They were both far more effective in commanding fear, whilst Doflamingo was just kinda cool. And that had a very detrimental effect on him as a primary antagonist. As much as I love the character, I can't legitimately say I was ever truly threatened by him during the Dressrosa saga. Not in the same way that I felt threatened by anyone else I've compared him to. And you know what, I'll even throw another name into this mix, which is Crocodile. A significantly weaker existence than Doflamingo, but his presence was overwhelming due to him using what he had, be it strength, intelligence, and devil fruit abilities, to a much higher antagonistic level. And speaking of the I word, intelligence is a questionable area when it comes to Doflamingo. Everything about where his character is in the series would suggest that he has a high degree of it, and that's part of what built him up to be this amazing antagonist. However, almost every decision he made during the Dressrosa arc very much undermines that idea and lessens his potency as a villain to me as a result. Things like casually deciding that he was going to try and kill a Marine Admiral, or even more puzzlingly, deciding not to kill Trafalgar Law for no reason on multiple occasions, as well as being so arrogant that he actually allowed the Meramara no Mi to be put in a chest as a prize in the Corridor Coliseum when he had no intention of losing it. And the thing with that last one is it just doesn't make sense whatever way you look at it. Even if we took Doflamingo's view that Diamante had a 100% chance of winning the contest, then there is still no point in putting the actual devil fruit in that chest. And should there be a less than 100% chance of Diamante's victory, then it is a wildly unnecessary risk that resulted in a superpowered Sabo becoming heavily involved in the events that culminated in Doflamingo's downfall. And the generally accepted reason for all of this is of course Doflamingo's wild arrogance, which is a fatal flaw. All characters have at least one of these and arguably need one, which is fine. I just personally don't feel like a lot of his decision making is consistent with the character as presented in his position of importance in the world. But none of that is to say that Doflamingo is a weak villain because of that. He is incredible and he was capable of helming an entire saga by giving us just enough of everything to provide a really solid presence. However, to me, that just is not enough, not in a series like One Piece anyway, to label him as one of the top 5 best villains. I mean, he's up there, probably quite close to the top 5 even, maybe like 7th or 8th, but there is so much more that this world has to offer, and a whole slew of antagonists out there who deserve that recognition more. But that pretty much does it for whatever this rambling business was. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produced in general, then please do consider donating to the Grand Line Review Patreon, because the support of all of you amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. And if you'd like to see more videos like this but applied to other anime and manga series, then please do check out my second channel, New World Review, for all of your wider needs. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with your thoughts on Doflamingo as a villain. This has been the Grand Line Review, and I'll see you next time.
This is Grand Line Review, and I'm Grand Line Waifu. Have a great day, everyone. Have a great day.
What if they don't want to?
Well, then have a shitty day. Jeez, I'm not in charge of you. Do what you want to do. Have a bad day. Have a really bad day. You know what? You know what? I take it back. Don't have a good day. You don't get a good day. If you wanted a bad day, you don't deserve to have a good day. So, no. You know what? Just, it's nighttime now. It's night.
No, it's not.
It's night. You don't even get a day.
You just came in here for an umbrella.
I came in for an umbrella, and you know what? I'm laying down the law. It's not daytime. It's nighttime now, and you only get night. Eternal night.
You forgot the dog.
Eternal night.
Well, you all just got told.